Hi, I'm Pastor Kim from Wall Street United Church in Brockville, Ontario. Happy Advent. The whole world has been watching and following Princess Kate as we've found out that she's pregnant, and I can't help but in this season of Advent compare her or think about her and think about Mary at the same time, pregnant with the Son of God. And Princess Kate has this, you know, amazing title of Her Royal Highness the Duchess of Cambridge. And yet when we look at Mary, she had no title at all. She wasn't special at all. She didn't even come from Rome or from Alexandria, not even Jerusalem or Bethlehem. She came from Nazareth. Just a couple of weeks ago, I was doing a funeral for a man who died quite suddenly. And during the meditation, I talked about how he had lived in the town of Roebuck all his life. Well, as I said this in this packed church, all of a sudden somebody blurted out, "Town?" Everyone started laughing. You see, Roebuck does not qualify as a town. In fact, it doesn't even qualify as a village. I found out later that I think hamlet is the term you would describe a community of that size. It doesn't even have a postal code. It's a nowhere place. Well, Nazareth was a bit like Roebuck, and perhaps a bit like the community that you live in. No one had heard of it. Mary wasn't even on the who's list in Nazareth. She was no one. And yet she was chosen to be the Mother of God. Now that's a title. So what was it about her? Well, one of the big things is that Mary was willing to say yes. She was willing to surrender and let go of her own ego, her own hopes and dreams for what her life would be like, and to allow God's dream to be born in her. It wasn't an easy road ahead, as I'm sure you know. But when we surrender our will and our goals for God's, something amazing is born. You see, this Christmas story isn't just history. It's not just something we remember that happened 2,000 some odd years ago. God wants to be born in you today. Do you have the humility? Do you have the courage to say, "Here I am. Let it be with me according to your will. I am your humble servant," as Mary said. When we do that, God comes into our life and creates something extraordinary. Not just for us, but for our community around us, for our world. My hope and prayer today is that you will let the Son of God be born in you today, that you will let Jesus into your heart, that you will be open to God's will and to God's incredible life. Let's say a prayer. Holy and awesome God, we give you thanks for this season and this time of year. God, help us to remember that this story is not just history, that you are alive and that you long to fill us with new life, even ordinary people like us from incredibly ordinary places in Canada. And we pray a special prayer for our ordinary United Church. God, we pray that you would be born in each one of us and in our church, that something extraordinary for your purpose might take place. Thanks be to God. Amen. Thanks.